Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian getting set to bring you this one on the show. Alongside me are Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, a good matchup on the mound here in this opener.
Yeah, and as you look at the numbers here, we've still got a guy looking for his very first victory on the season. Ideally, he'd have one by now, but some of it's been his own problems, and some of it can be attributed to the lack of run support. But however you look at it, you know he'd love to get that first W under his belt.
More from the guys as this one goes along, but first, let's take a look here at the starting lineup for the visiting Chicago White Sox, as Robin Ventura has them lined up this way. They'll have to go to work against a tough assignment indeed, as there you see the numbers for the hard-throwing right-hander Matt Garza. One pitch is swung on and hit in the air out to center field. Gomez will wait on it. One gone. So the leadoff man is gone following the fly out to center. And with that, let's take a look at the Brewers defensively. It's brought to us by the folks at Majestic. If it happens in baseball, it happens in Majestic. Into the box now, Adam Eaton. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. EK, we take a look at the home nine as they take the field here tonight. They come off another loss last time out, and in fact, they've dropped three of their last four.
And that last loss dropped them back to the 500 mark on the year. So obviously, they'd like to get back into that positive number for the win here.
And he lays off here, ball four, and he'll become the game's first base runner here with one away.
And it really helps having kind of a second leadoff man hitting in that number two hole. He's on now with one away, and he may get a chance to run in the early going.
On that one. Two balls and a strike.
Yeah, he didn't seem to do him any favors with the previous batter, and now here's another call that goes against him on the mound.
Swing and a ball chop foul down the left side. Two pitch. Don't quite know where that one missed, but it's not for me to decide. 3-2. 3-2, one out. You got him running at first.
First inning? Yeah, why not?
From the belt, kicks and deals. Now a swing and a ground ball, and that's a fair ball as this one gets by him at third. The throw to third, and he's safe. Into the box, Melky Cabrera pitches a cold strike. The throw back by Segura. They're going to get him at second base.
Well, with one away in the inning, they're thinking they'd like to get a second runner into scoring position. And that was wishful thinking because a good throw takes care of him trying to steal second.
Now, fastball swung on and missed, and that is out number three. A man left for the White Sox. Now it's the Brew Crew's turn in a scoreless ball game. Starting lineup for the Brewers looks like this. They'll match up against a former wide receiver turned reliever turned starter, the hard-throwing right-hander Jeff Samardzija. Behind him, the White Sox defensively will line up like this.
No,
tried to get him to chase the cutter there, a ball and two strikes. Here comes a 1-2. He goes after the pitch on the outer half and pops it weakly toward the left side of the infield. With that, we'll take a look at our scouting report. You can see a 5-pitch repertoire, so mixing those pitches effectively will be a key as we move along. Swing and a ball hit fairly well, heading high and deep toward right center. And this will be taken in out there just a few steps in front of the track, and there are two away now. In now, Jonathan Lucroy. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. And a bit of a high throw that time, but not much problem over there at first, as that will end the inning. And inning in the books tonight, still scoreless here on the show. Standing in now, Avisail Garcia. Just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Here comes the pitch for Garcia. Well hit, but also well fouled into the seats and left. Here now the 2-2. Hit hard right back up the middle, and he's got a leadoff single.
As we look at that again, you know, this is not a bad pitch by any stretch. If he throws this pitch 10 times, I bet he gets him out 9 of them. But here you just have to tip your cap to the guy at the plate.
I had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2. Here comes the 1-2. Breaking ball misses the corner. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Two pitch on the way. Swing and a ball hit to the left side, and this is going to wind up a souvenir. Ready with another 2-2. That misses, and it's going to set up a big pitch now. 3-2. You have to figure that he's really going to need to keep the walks in check if he's going to have success here.
I was thinking the same thing. No free rides. You've got to make these guys earn it.
And he misses here for ball 4. Already 2 walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work. Stepping in now, Giovanni Soto. And that misses, 2-1.
And you know, all you have to do is point back to yesterday's ball game. This was part of their downfall, hitting with runners in scoring position. They just couldn't sustain any kind of offense. So this would be a big boost if he could turn the tide a little bit here and come through big.
Here's the 2-2 home. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning. Number 7 will stand in, and he was among the many who failed to record a base hit in the loss yesterday. Into the box, number 7. Ground ball to second. This could be 2. Segura for 1. And now after that call at second, here comes the skipper out of the third base dugout as he apparently doesn't agree with the call. I believe the second base umpire is going to tell him that the drop occurred on the transfer, but that's not going to sit well with the skipper, so you can just about guarantee that he's going to have his say before he returns to the dugout.
Let's do it, guys.
In now, Jeff Samardzija.
1 ball.
Gets him to swing at a pitch down and out of the zone. 1-2. No score here as we play inning number 2. A big pitch here, 1-2. And this is swung on and missed, though the ball did hit the ground, so he'll need to go to first. And the throw is in time. It's a strikeout, and the play at first goes 2-3 for good measure as the inning is over. Into the box now, Ryan Braun. Now a swing as he hits this one into the air. Well, this will be foul off to the right, out of play. Here's the full count offering. And he takes ball 4. Leadoff man's aboard here to begin the home half of the second.
Hey, you know what? That's all right. He gave him a pretty good battle up there, and he never gave in to him. A walk you can work around. A home run, you can't.
Standing in now, Adam Lind. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
And after that pitch was called a ball on the pitch before, I mean, I think this actually qualifies as strike four. You know, on the mound, he's probably thinking, hey, can I apply the credit to the next guy?
Bottom of the second here with no score.
Come on, Milwaukee.
Come set, now the pitch. Swing and a hard liner to center field. And that'll be a base hit, the first one of the game for the Brewers. Into the box, Aramis Ramirez. And this will be fouled away. One and two with one away. And that's in there for a called third strike on the split-fingered fastball, two away.
Well, even though it's just the second inning, you sure don't want to get in the habit of leaving runners in scoring position. So now this next at-bat is going to be a pretty telling one early on.
And he takes ball four. So now at least they're set up for the force at any base here with two away. In now, Matt Garza. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Now the 1-2. Here's a swing and a ground ball. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Again, a 1-2. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. Big pitch here, 1-2. Now this is on the ground to second. Is he going to get out of this? Over to first. He does get out of it, and the inning is over. A couple of walks, but no damage. Back with more Monday Night Baseball following this. Into the box now, Alexi Ramirez. Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And he'll indeed make the play in foul territory for the first down.
Now that'll be a frustrating at-bat for him. Now he's got to be thinking he let one get away there because, you know, that's a pitch he should have been able to handle.
And this is heading out toward left field, but this is going to get fouled up into the crowd. 2-2. Full count now. 3-2. Jose Abreu waits on deck. Full count pitch on its way. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a walk.
Now in a scoreless game, I've got a hunch he may get a green light here. He may want to try and get something started that way.
Stepping in now, Jose Abreu. And I believe they'll say he broke the plane, as yes, he did. It's ruled a strike. Sets the 2-2 pitch. And now a slider in there for a called third strike, and there are two gone now. Standing in now, Melky Cabrera. Swinging a ball hit softly on the ground. Throw in time, and the side is retired. White Sox leave one. Home half of the third coming up. No score. In now, Gene Segura. Swing, and he takes this the other way to right. And a base hit, so early trouble to lead off the inning.
Pretty good swing there. You'll watch. Head stays down, ball gets deep in the zone, and he lets those hands lead the way, and he drives to the right field. That's as good an approach as you're going to see.
Oh, and he can't come up with it. Here's Segura around third, heading for the plate. And the run will score as the Brewers are off to an early 1-0 lead.
And every hitter knows you're going to see more fastballs when you've got good speed over there at first base. And that's exactly what he gets here as he drives this one. And of course, because of that speed, that runner's going to come all the way around and score from first base.
Oh, yeah, the right-hander deals on 1-2. Swing and he pops him up. Behind the bag at second. And the catch will be made here by Ramirez, one gone.
This ball is not hit all that hard, but still, that's a nice job of ranging back onto the outfield grass to take it in.
Into the box now, Ryan Braun. And this is taken for a called strike. Oh, that's a tough call. Now 1-2.
Well, he's been in a tough stretch offensively, and this sure ain't gonna help.
Fouled back. He'll try again, 1-2. Has to fight to stay alive as this is fouled off to the right. Here's another 1-2. And a splitter swung on and missed that time, and that'll be out number two. Stepping in now, Adam Lind. Lays off his slider that time, 2-1.
Yeah, and when that pitch starts off outside, it's much easier to get a better view of it and then just lay off.
A 2-1 offering. And this is fouled back and out of play. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. The 2-2 coming. And this one runs in on him as he can't get his arms extended. A great pitch there, and the inning is over. Brewers get a run on the RBI double. We're through three here in southern Wisconsin. It's now 1-0 Milwaukee. Into the box, Avisail Garcia. Down low, two balls and a strike. Here he comes on 2-1. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two.
A little conviction behind that fastball.
Here comes a 2-2. And this is hit hard on the ground to first. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. And now, fortunately, they will get an out here.
Well, in most cases, once he kicks this thing, it's going to be a sure error. But luckily for him, he's got a diesel tanker headed down the first baseline. So he's able to gather this thing up and still get the out at first.
He'll take this in without much trouble, and two are gone here to start the fourth. So with two gone here in the fourth, let's check out our pitch speed comparison for the two starters. And as you see there, just 1 mile an hour separating these two arms so far. 96 on one hand, 95 on the other. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Down in order go the White Sox. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Standing in now, Carlos Gomez. Now a swing and a sharp ground ball to third. Throws in time, and that's out number one. In now, Aramis Ramirez. 1-2 now as that's in there at the knees. Here's the 1-2. And that's off his leg on the mound. And now, fortunately, they will get an out here. And with that play over now, time to check and see if our man is all right. You can really see him favoring that leg. And that is his plant leg, which is always a concern. But from the way he's acting out there, I think it looks like he's going to be okay to try and continue. Into the box now, Chris Davis. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. Here's the 2-1 pitch. To 2-2 now.
2-2.
Here he comes on 2-2. Pitch in the dirt, swung on and missed for strike three, as they'll need to throw to first here. And the throw to first will indeed get him. It's a strikeout, score at 2-3, and the inning is over. Three up, three down for Milwaukee, but they're on top 1-0. Number seven will dig in. 0-1 here in this one. Into the box, number seven. And that's swung on and fouled straight back. Here's the 3-2 pitch. A little late on this one as it's lifted the other way down the left field line. And this is going to be extra bases here to kick off the fifth. And he gets in there standing. He's got himself a double. So quickly into scoring position here following the opposite field double. And as we give you a look at the White Sox leaderboard, you can see his total there. Currently second best on the ball club. Stepping in now, Jeff Samardzija. And he'll try and get his man to third here as he puts this one down. And you can't ask for much more out of a pitcher than that. The sacrifice works to perfection.
Yeah, down by a run, they're not taking any chances here. They want to tie this ball game up. And the sacrifice moves a man to third here with just one away.
Standing in now, Alexi Ramirez.
Two balls and two strikes
now. Gotta say, for a strikeout pitcher, not too many strikeouts here so far.
And he's in a big need of one right here. It would definitely come in handy.
He did well to get a piece that time, and it'll stay 2-2. He waits. Now the pitch.
Sweet.
And this ball is also hit foul and heading for the seats, so we'll have to do it again. Still 2-2. He's set. Now the pitch. And struck him out.
Well, he's done a pretty good job here of rendering that leadoff double useless. He's come back with a ground out, then a strikeout, and so now it's going to come down to a two-out base hit if they want to score right here.
In now, Adam Eaton. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Here it comes, 2-1. And, ooh, that strike zone's getting a little inconsistent now. It's 2-2.
Yeah, he must have been looking for that same breaking ball because that pitch, it's right there.
Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. Jose Abreu would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Now the payoff pitch home. Now here's the ball hit hard on the ground towards short. Throw not nearly in time as he reaches it first. And the run will score from third as that ties things at one.
Well, that's one way to get yourself on the scoreboard for the first time. They always say, get that runner home any way you can. And, well, this counts. It'll be scored an infield single and an RBI.
Into the box now, Jose Abreu. Swing and a line drive to left. Davis is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Sox get a run here on two hits. Home half of the fifth coming up. All tied at 1-1. Stepping in now, Matt Garza. That one finds the target on the outer half. It's 1-2.
Real good lateral movement on that two-seam fastball. That pitch is money for him when it's moving like that. So just keep on throwing it.
Swing and a miss, and he'll start the fifth the same way he ended the fourth, with a punch out, one away. Standing in now, Gene Segura. 1-1 pitch is a slider that's cut on and missed for strike two.
He's just cruising out there now. I'll tell you, this may turn into a game of first team to two wins.
A late swing here as this is hit hard to the right side. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Now another 1-2. A late swing here as this is hit hard to the right side. Foul. Again, a 1-2. This ball will be chopped foul. Bases are empty, one man out. Here he comes again, 1-2. Swing and a miss as he starts the frame with back-to-back strikeouts here. Three in a row going back to the last inning, and there are two away. In now, Scooter Gennett. Misses, ball two. One run on three hits, and no errors on the Milwaukee line score so far. And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. We're back with more on this Monday night after this. Action now in the Milwaukee bullpen as they'll have a right-hander loosen up. Into the box now, Melky Cabrera. Now a swing and a hard-hit ball to short. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth.
Here's a look at his pitches by inning so far. That last one was number 84, so they're getting near the point where they'll need to start keeping tabs on him.
Stepping in now, Avisail Garcia. Here's a ball lined up and over the head of Segura at short. It's on into left center for a base hit.
You think he was looking for a fastball there? I think he was. That's about as hard a hit ball as you're going to see, and he was right on that one.
Now a fastball as he has to lean out of the way there. Can't imagine guys like that too much.
Yeah, not too much indeed. You start getting into the danger area when it's up and in that high.
Now a drive out to left center field, and that's going to wind up splitting Davis and Gomez and rolling all the way to the wall. Around third and being waved on home. Now it's cut off, a throw to the plate, and the runner will score from first.
Give that runner credit from first base. Sometimes on a deep fly ball like that, you can get caught up either going into a home run trot too early or waiting up to see if the ball would be caught. But he had his head down the whole way, and he's going to come all the way around to score.
Brandon Kinsler will come out and take the ball here as he'll be making his 15th appearance of the year. Into the box, Giovanni Soto. Now a ball hit foul down the line in right and in amongst the fans. The next 3-2. Bouncing ball back up the middle. Throw gets him, two down. Number seven will dig in. One for two with a double in this one. In now, number seven. And a sinker there, swung on and missed for out number three. Sox get one on the RBI double. Bottom of the sixth coming up. It's now 2-1 Chicago. Standing in now, Jonathan Lucroy. Lined into left center. And that'll split the gap as it should be extra bases. And this will get to the wall now out near the Milwaukee bullpen. And he's in there safely. He's got a double.
Out on the mound, just got on the board, taking the lead, and you're hoping for a quick shutdown inning. But this guy's got other plans because he drills this ball. He's going to wind up on second with a leadoff double.
And some stirring now in the White Sox bullpen as it looks like a right-hander's up and throwing. He'll try again, 1-2. Struck him out, and he becomes the ninth strikeout victim thus far.
Well, right now, that fastball's been so good, he really hasn't needed any of his secondary pitches. Another good heater there.
Stepping in now, Adam Lind. Think he held up in time, but that becomes moot as it's a called strike two.
And in this spot, you got to pitch for the strikeout here. And this is a guy that's gone down twice so far, so you do have that in your favor.
Payoff pitch coming. Now a ball lined toward right center, and he'll have himself a base hit. Garcia gets it back in, and that'll hold the runner at third base.
Yeah, and about the only drawback you have to having so many strikeouts is that it really runs that pitch count up. You can see on the graphic right here that that total's starting to get up there now. So he may be getting just a little bit tired.
And he struck him out. And wouldn't this be something if he could work out of this with that one-run lead still in check?
Well, not only is that 10 strikeouts now, but I'll tell you what, we've still got a few innings to go here. He keeps throwing the way he is. He can make that number really interesting by the time this one's through.
And a slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2. That man's team has definitely shot itself in the foot with all the strikeouts so far.
Seems like it's been a
great. I'm sorry to interrupt, but that's the third strike and the third out. Side is retired. Brewers strand a couple. They still trail it here 2-1. Back here at Miller Park in Milwaukee. White Sox on top in this one, but before we get out to the seventh, let's take a look at our game summary through the first six.
Easy strikeout here.
Into the box, Jeff Samardzija. Now here's a comebacker back to the mound. And a flip on to first to record the out. Into the box now, Alexi Ramirez. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. Here's the pitch. That's hard hit back up the middle. Over to his left, he's up with it. In time to first, and there are two away.
Let's go.
Standing in now, Adam Eaton. Here's a fly ball now, lifted in the air out to right. Braun is there, makes the catch, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the White Sox. They lead it 2-1. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Stepping in now, Chris Davis. Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1.
Down by a run, your guys need you on base any way you can get there. Now you got to shrink that strike zone down and not go after anything that's not right there for you.
And this is down at the knees, but called a strike. Wow, it's 3-2 now.
Oh, another good pitch there. I'm not sure he's throwing a bad slider tonight. Every one of them has had a ton of movement.
Right field. Garcia is in his tracks now, and he's got it for the first out. Gerardo Parra will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run. We're in the seventh inning now of a pitcher's duel. 2-1 our score. And he stays alive as this is grounded foul. Now another 1-2. And 2-2.
Keep in mind now, the longer this at-bat goes, the higher the likelihood that this becomes his last inning out there.
He's just rolling right now, and even dozen strikeouts for him in the ballgame.
And the way this guy's pitching, you can bet these guys are thinking, thank goodness he's over in the other league. I'd hate to face him.
And hold that thought as that's a strikeout for route number three, so the inning will come to an end. Gone in order are the Brewers. Our score remains 2-1. Will Smith will be summoned from the bullpen now as he'll take over to start inning number 8. Now some movement out in the Milwaukee bullpen. Both a lefty and a right-hander have begun to stretch it out. Into the box, Jose Abreu. Now a ball swung on and heading for the stands in right, and that'll move the count to 1-2 now. Hit hard, but foul toward first, so he'll come back and line it up again. Here's another 1-2. And this is hit well towards the hole. And that'll just sneak past his outstretched arm, a base hit.
Right
Well, these guys have been high on effort, but low on results so far. They're still stuck on two runs, but at least they've got a leadoff base runner here to start this inning.
In now, Melky Cabrera. Now a ball fouled down the right field line out of play, so that'll move the count to 2-2 now. 2-2. And fastball got him looking. As that had two-seam action on it, one gone. Good guys leading this one on the road here in the eighth as you get a look at our line score at this point. Into the box now, Avisail Garcia. High and wide, two balls and a strike. Here comes the pitch for Garcia. Now a swing and a hard hit grounder. And that's through for a base hit. And he'll move up to third now. Runners at the corners here with one away.
Boy, if you want to draw up what a perfect hit and run looks like, use a tape of this at-bat right here. With the right-handed hitter up there, the second baseman's forced to go cover second. And this ball is just slapped right into the big hole that he just vacated. That's absolutely textbook right there.
And he gets some pretty good wood on it here as this is lifted to fairly deep left. Davis the catch, tagging is the runner from third. And add a run on the sacrifice fly as that'll make this a 3-1 game.
Good job there to pick up an insurance run here on the sacrifice fly. The way their starter's throwing, he may not even need it, but I bet he'll be grateful for that extra cushion, no doubt.
Jim Henderson will take over here with a runner at first and two gone in the inning. Stepping in now, Giovanni Soto. Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2. Right-hander starts to loosen out in the bullpen now. Now the 2-2 pitch. Got him on a good slider there. Swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight. Sox get a run here on two hits. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. It's the White Sox 3 and the Brewers 1. Standing in now, Scooter Gennett. Now a ball hit high down the left field line, but back in amongst the spectators, foul. Now the 3-2 pitch. And he goes and chops this one out towards second. A quick out number one. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. In now, Jonathan Lucroy. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, but this is back into the seats, a foul ball. Full count pitch on its way. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he tucks out a walk. Into the box now, Ryan Braun. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now. Is that really the spot you want to be messing with here?
Shouldn't be. That's a danger zone if you ask me.
Good plate discipline to lay off the slider that time, and he draws even a 2-2.
Yeah, that's a great pitch on 1-2. Start it in the zone, and hopefully you'll get that guy thinking he needs to protect. Turned out to be a good take.
Here now the 2-2. Swing and a ground ball to first. Ramirez for one. The relay not in time as he beats the throw by a step.
This is always a tough throw here for a first baseman coming off the bag. You got to make sure that you don't just throw the ball right into the runner's back heading down to second base. Here he takes just a little extra time to make sure that he makes a good throw. And they're going to settle for just one at second.
Into the box, Adam Lind. Swing and a hard hit ball to second. Oh, look at this. From a knee, he throws him out. A remarkable play there to retire the side. Three thumbs up here in the booth following this gorgeous play at second base. Back with more Monday Night Baseball following this. Number 7 will get us started as they look for a little insurance here in the top of the ninth. Stepping in now, number 7, And able to lay off the fastball away here. 2-1 now. The 2-1 home. Now a slider misses, and that pushes the count to 3-1.
And this is a nice job so far out of that number 8 hole. Taking some pitches, trying to get on, leading off the inning.
Now the 3-1 home. Over towards the dugout, but this one will get into the stands. Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the ninth. J.B. Shuck will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. One out, nobody on. Line fouled off to the left and a few rows back. Yeah. 1-2. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. And the pitch. And now this ball's lifted in the air down the right field line, but this will get back into the seats, so the count holds at 2-2. Here it comes. And he takes ball 3, so it's a full count now.
And there you see the leadoff man on deck, and you know they'd love to get someone on base when this lineup turns over.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down.
Hard to do much better than this. Here are the only 3 batters he's faced since coming on. Strikeout, strikeout, and strikeout. Boy, that is flat dealing there.
Standing in now, Alexi Ramirez. 2-2 now, with 2 away, and the base is empty.
Oh, the crowd thought they had him, but definitely outside. Not by a whole lot, though.
Two-two pitch on the way. Now here's a ball popped up. Playable, however, for Lucroy behind the plate. And he will indeed make the play in foul territory to retire the side. Down in order go the White Sox, and it's still 3-1. David Robertson is on now to try to close things down here in the ninth. Some action now in the White Sox bullpen. They'll stand up a lefty and a right-hander to throw. Into the box now, Carlos Gomez. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike.
You got to think one thing here. Get on base. A walk will do the trick.
Now here's the pitch. Now he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory on the right side. Abreu is there, and that's not the start to the bottom of the ninth this crowd was hoping for. 1 away.
Well, this is what you want out of your closer. Comes in firing darts, and it's a very quick out number 1.
Come on, let's get a hit.
Into the box, Aramis Ramirez. Hard hit down the line. And he'll take this on to first, and they're down to their final out, 2 away.
Yeah, and now just 1 out away from wrapping up this one, and that would certainly be a good way to start the series if they could take game 1 on the road.
In now, Chris Davis. And this will be a called strike 2. In trouble now as they're down to their final strike tonight. Three and two, here it is. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Another payoff pitch. Hit hard, but foul. Full count offering on its way. And that misses as Davis will reach. It's ball four.
Great at bat there. Just the guy is just one out away from finishing this up. I mean, you've got one job to do at the plate, and that's to get on base any way you can. Now, even with two outs, game's not over yet.
And that's swung on and missed, so the Brewers are down to their final strike now.
Just overmatched him there.
The 1-2. Ball two.
I thought he was going to get rung up on that one.
I would agree. If that missed, it didn't miss by much.
Here's the 2-2 home. Now a ball hit fouled off to the right and up into the crowd. The 2-2 one more time. And he's getting his money's worth up there now. It's full 3-2.
And obviously a walk here would be a big no-no with two outs in the ninth. You cannot put that tying run on base.
Here's the payoff pitch. Swung on and taken the opposite way out toward deep left center. And this will be just what the manager ordered as he's off the bench with extra bases. And the runner will score from first.
3-2, he gets a head start over there at first base, and it's going to wind up paying dividends. He's able to come all the way around to score on the double.
Standing in now, Gene Segura. Line drive, caught! Oh, my, he crushed that ball, but the tying run will end up stranded at second, and the ball game is over.
Well, this one certainly wasn't a spotless finish, that's for sure. He does surrender a run, but he also gets the final out here to pick up the save.
This one, definitely a low-scoring affair as we get one last look at our final line score.